It's the All-Ireland champions Limerick taking on Cork this afternoon, live from the LIT Gaelic Grounds for a win at 4 o'clock. These two sides gave us so much drama last year, both in Munster and at Croke Park. And although Cork looked disinterested in the league at times this year, they made sure to put in a big performance against John Kiely's Limerick. We'll be getting team confirmation shortly from Dirk Canning and Michael Dignan. But first, our reporter Ivan Cullen caught up with the Cork manager John Myler and his Limerick counterpart John.
John, is there an advantage to having a week off at the start, or are you like coiled springs now, raring to go?
Yeah, I suppose there are advantages and disadvantages. You know, you'd like to get up and running as early as you can too, but at the same time you get a chance to see the opposition maybe in their game as well. So there's pluses and for and against, but ultimately, listen, the day is coming and we're ready to go.
Well, you did get to watch your opposition and Cork beat you here during the league. Are you expecting a bite back after their defeat last week?
Yeah, listen, of course there's going to be a response from them. You know, every good team has that response in them. So, you know, it's just how we react to that. You know, ultimately our focus is on our own game and our own game plan and our own attitude and getting that right first and foremost, because if that's right, it doesn't matter what the opposition will bring.
You had a good win here during the league. You're winning as Munster champions. Have you taken confidence from that during the week?
Yeah, there was a huge emphasis we put on the league match here, and you know, I mean, they really played well that day, and if we can get something near that and more, then we'll be happy. And you know, it's really about the performance today and to be competitive.
Now, you've no changes to your team from the programme. Can we expect to see Alan Cadogan in at all today?
Well, Alan is back training and is fit to go, raring to go, but he's played very little hurling in the last 12 months, but you know, he's a welcome bonus off the sideline. Shane Kingston as well.
The two managers there in determined mood. I'm glad to have Michael Dignan here with me. Well, Michael, if it's anything like last year, those two real classic matches in Munster and again in the semi-final. High scoring, very exciting. More of the same, please.
Yeah, there doesn't seem to be much between both of these teams. Limerick obviously coming in as All-Ireland champions, 14 of last year's team. Cork making a number of changes from last week. So look, Limerick favourites for me, but to have a good record against Limerick and expect them not to go down without a fight, but Limerick to win.
Okay, well, I can tell you that the minor match finished level. Let's check on the teams then for the senior game. Host Limerick are in the happy position of being able to name 14 of the 15 players who started last year's All-Ireland final. And that includes fullback Mike Casey, who went off injured in that match and missed most of the Alliance League campaign. His brother Peter is the only change from that momentous day. He comes in place of Seamus Flanagan to join forces with Aaron Gillan, who had an outstanding start to this season, and the team's most experienced championship player, who is Graham Mulcahy. Well, following last week's loss in Portiquive, Cork make four changes. Robert Downey, who played here against Limerick in the league, starts at wing-back, while Mark Ellis gets a recall at number six, to the exclusion of Tim O'Mahony. Bill Cooper has recovered sufficiently from his back complaint and lines up at centre field, while back into the starting lineup at corner forward comes Aidan Walsh. After the over-dependence last week on Patrick Horgan, the other forwards will probably be on message to shake things up. Limerick's subs list includes obvious forward options in Shane Dowling and Seamus Flanagan, but such is the strength of the squad, I think just getting into the match day 26 is quite an achievement in itself. While Cork will be happy to have Alan Cadogan available once again and may re-evaluate where they might play Tim O'Mahony. And then, of course, there's Shane Kingston, so unlucky not to start. Well, we'll be starting here at 4 o'clock, Joanne.
And we absolutely cannot wait. The noise is unbelievable here in Limerick. And we've been talking about how there's so much pressure in Cork because they really have to get a win or at least a draw this afternoon. But what about the pressure in Limerick? They're coming here. They're All-Ireland champions. The crowd is so expectant.
Yeah, and that's the thing I was thinking this morning. And even in the interviews during the week, talking about we don't have a Munster medal, we want them in the Munster championship. That talk wasn't around here this time 12 months ago. You know, they were just focused on that Limerick game. And that is the expectation that's going to come on. And because the performances during the league was probably a level above what they showcased last year. So that all brings the expectation that things are going well, things are going well. And I suppose until you get in the white heat of battle, you just don't know. So, but look, to be fair, the way they've carried themselves, even the very simple things last year when the Liam McCarthy Cup was torn. It wasn't like Anthony's time where I went to every pub in Clare and West Clare and spent there a lot of time out there. The cup didn't touch a public house. And those small things, I think John Kiely has managed things very well. And he just said in his interview there, it's about ourselves and looking after ourselves.
Did you bring it to any pub, no?
No. We did the first couple of years.
The first couple of years. You were on the tenth one, you didn't bother.
That is essentially what he was saying. Cork last week, obviously most question marks hung around once again their defence, and John Myler has made big changes in personnel there.
He has. He has made massive calls. Robert Downey coming in, a young lad, but look at last week, John, some of this stuff was juvenile defending. I mean, Niall O'Mara's fallen, four of them go to swarm him, like when the swarm wasn't on, and leaving Shamie Callan and buries it in the back of the net. I mean, that's juvenile defending to me, and just it's spatial awareness that's lacking, like that's what I would say. And here, like, hip were very sharp by comparison to touch, but they were away from him and gone, like, in front for the ball, making the runs, like, do you know, Bubbles making a run, Damien Callan in his way, couldn't get near him. Like, this, again, criminal. Beautiful ball from McGrain. But the speed, I mean, and the chasing back here, the lads. Yeah. I mean, you wouldn't actually get it in a juvenile game. You'd say, lads, will you hold your shape some bit? And, of course, John McGrath will finish those all day. And John Myler, to me, he has restructured. A huge call with young Downey. Hasn't played under 21 yet, under 20. This minor full forward 2 years ago.
Do you know him, Donalogue?
Yeah, well, look, it's a bit of a surprise, right? It's a surprise that maybe we didn't move Tim from centre back out to wing back, played here in the league, actually played in the minor final in the forward line, like Anthony said. But the defence, I think, it starts from the front. We know that, right? Yeah, so Aidan Watts is picked in the full forward line today. He needs to be pushing out into the half-forward line. Daniel Carney and Luke Mead, they need to be making the likes of Kyle Hayes' life hell when they come out from that their half-forward line. That allows the Cork half-back line, at least one of them, to sit in front of the Cork full-back line.
Oh, but check, day is check it out. That won't be too easy making...
That's what needs to happen. Yeah. And the day is gone for an inside defender being able to mark a man one-on-one, especially the way the referees are calling the games. And today, like, you've got Niall O'Leary. I'm really looking forward to seeing him against Aaron Gillan. Aaron Gillan is a terrific player, right? Comes into the game in the high. Young O'Leary kept him scoreless in the Fitzgibbon Cup final. But I think it's critical. Mead and Carney, for me, are fundamental coming out into that middle eight. And that's actually what gives the half-back line opportunity to protect the inside
line. And Cooper having to go off just before the game. Obviously, that affected maybe to go back and pick up Bubbles' role. But I find the Mark Ellis thing intriguing as well, John. Like, I mean, he's in his jeans and a top watching the match and went off and played a football match for Mill Street after the game last Sunday. And he sent her half back here against...
Well, you did question during the week whether the players had faith in the manager. That's harsh after one championship game.
It is. And we'll see how it's borne out. Is the response off him now? I'd love to see it. They were terrible last week, I thought.
But even separate to that, right? Look, I played in teams where you didn't have faith in the manager. But would non-negotiable, when you were going to war to play for Cork, you're going to war to play for Cork in the story. And often won games when we didn't believe in the manager. And today, Cork will come to Limerick. Limerick are All-Ireland champions. Cork will have no fear of coming down here to play. And if any of do, they shouldn't be playing for Cork. I'm actually expecting a huge performance from Cork today, and I think Cork are going to win.
Do you find it strange that Donalogue says that he thinks Cork are going to win? Cork got within a piece of brilliance from Nicky Quaid of an All-Ireland final last year, won the Munster Championship, and Anthony's sitting there saying he doesn't think the players have faith in their manager.
Yeah, there's a load of question, obviously, so there's a lot in it. But I do think Cork will win. I do think Cork will win, because I think they have to have faith, and we were talking earlier on off camera again about the belief. Cork can believe they can come up here and win it because they have it in their psyche to do that. But I think there is question marks around their level of performance last week, especially on the back of a league performance where Tippin annihilated them down, and that's why I expected Cork would come with something last week. And I think today is the day they'll have to come with something.
You obviously want to clarify something, do you?
I didn't say they had no faith in their manager. I questioned on the back of last week's performance. Had they, from last year was John's first year in charge, obviously no manager, you're not going to, you know. But I just thought the younger players, Joanne, to me, they didn't show what they showed. I'm talking Luke Mead, Shane Kingston dropped. I find that bizarre, the way he played the last day. Now, Donal, you made the point that maybe they're trying to keep a little bit more in reserve, which they didn't have against Limerick, I suppose, last year, obviously, is what we saw. But I just think for Robert Downey, Mark Ellis, Mark Coleman, not quite the player we saw last year either. No type of guy that could turn it on out here, like it's his stage and that. But they're going to come up against the most athletic and combative half-forward line in the country, who have now an All-Ireland medal in their pocket and have more of a swagger than Leicester. I don't think you can quantify, lads, what it has done to the Limerick side being champions.
Yeah, well, I'd be very interested in Mark Coleman, because if you looked at the league, Gillan, number 13 in that corner, you said you're in the league final,
There's so much ball goes into that corner. So I don't think Mark Coleman gets sucked out the field. He needs to be zonally marking that area because that's where Limerick cut in their attacks. I'll be very interested to see how that pans out today.
We do have to go, but Henry and Donal Logue are tipping Cork.
Sorry, I didn't tip Cork, no. I said there's a chance they could do it, but I do think Limerick will win.
I thought you said you expected them to win.
No.
So there's a chance that one of the two teams would win, yeah, but the other one's
not. No, I think Limerick at home.
These lads are sitting so much on the fence.
No. Anthony.
The last thing I'll be doing is sitting on the fence, because the fence will go down.
Limerick all the way.
Okay, let's head over to our commentary team for this one. They are Michael and Ger.
Thanks again, Joanne. Yes, it's a fabulous day here in Limerick. It's a full house as well. And as somebody was saying to me recently, when did you last see a full house here in what is now the LIT Gaelic Grounds in Limerick? And that reflects about 36, 37,000 people in here this afternoon, we are told. And before the action gets underway, there's going to be a minute's silence. It's in memory of Dennis Barrett, who was a selector with Limerick when they won the All-Ireland back in 1973 and sadly passed away recently. Eyesh Lob Day, Gareba on. Now, before the action gets underway, the pipe band to lead the crowd here in Limerick in the singing of our national anthem, Ar an Uimhin. Today is Paul O'Dwyer from Carlow. He's got Sean Clear and Shane Hayes. Shane is from Galway. Sean, of course, from Kilkenny as his linesman. Michael, it's going to be very interesting to see how Limerick are in form. 7 weeks since their last match, the league final.
Absolutely, and just something, Mike Casey very heavily bandaged at full-back. Tom Condon, who'd be recovered for the full-back line, out injured as well. So they'll be hoping he doesn't get injured early on.
And Limerick get the first possession here. It's with Dara O'Donovan in as far here is Tom Morrissey, and Morrissey looking to get the opening point of the match, but he's put it left instead. A great sense of expectation from the crowd. Disappointment for Tom Morrissey, first wide of the game. Goalkeeper for Cork, of course, is Anthony Nash, playing in his 35th championship match this afternoon. Cork won the toss, playing into the goal away on our left-hand side. The breeze is in Limerick's favour for the opening 35 minutes. Cian Lynch getting a possession here. The two centre-field players for Limerick have got their hands on the ball in the early stages. That's Daniel Carney quizzing that decision by the referee, but it's got to be a free-in and an opportunity for Limerick to get the opening point of the match. And the usual free-taker, of course, from this long distance is Diarmaid Burns, the LIT student. Player has scored 20 points in this year's National League, his best-ever league campaign. Well, he's 45 metres, well, a little more, 65 metres from the target. Having had a wide, this one is right between the uprights, and Limerick are off for the score.
Yeah, and interesting, that's well within Aaron Gillan's distance, but the brought Diarmaid Burns, obviously very, very good from play and from freeze, but It saves Galan maybe to trek out to the middle of the field as well.
Bill Cooper, happily recovered from that back spasm that forced him out of the match in Cork last Sunday at the 11th hour. In came Declan Hannan there to get to that one. Then coming out with it is Daniel Carney, and the referee blows the whistle, indicts the Limerick players, has a word with Dermot Burns, and it'll be a free for Cork and a chance for them to level up the scores in the very early stages of this match. Pitch is in wonderful condition, by the way. Great sense of expectation and anticipation all around Limerick before this match. All of that generated by Limerick's great win last year, reflected in the size of the crowd as well. There you were. Carney, yeah, going in.
Dermot Burns with a flick in, but Carney, quick hands, had it in his hand, definitely a free in, and Patrick Horgan didn't miss anything last weekend. Without him against Tipperary, things would have been a lot worse. He was outstanding.
Here he comes to put Cork on terms. Early stages, both points, the result of frees. Huge Cork, huge Limerick support here, as you would expect. Match two in the round robin series. Nicky Quaid pucking it out to right half forward this time. The target was Kyle Hayes. Wins it second time of asking. Back here as far as Darrow Donovan. Surrounded by three Cork players immediately. Waiting for that ball to pop out, and the referee decides it's not going to happen, so he's got to throw the ball in instead. Paul O'Dwyer in charge. So just two players meant to come in and compete for this one. Kian Lynch was one of them. Bill Cooper is the other. Two centre field players marking one another. Cooper has a go at it. Comes out there towards Luke Mead. Eventually taken back out by Kyle Hayes. That loose pass, however, easily picked up there by Mark Ellis. He'll be happy to get his first touch of the ball. Comes back here once again. Peter Casey this time. Into open space. Coming to collect it here is the debut man from last week, Niall O'Leary. Had a great debut. Touchdown this time by Connolly Hahn. Two Cork players get him on another's way. Finally it pops out again towards Connolly Hahn. Chance to put it over and put Cork in front. First point to come from open play. Scored by Connolly Hahn. Well, it was a little bit scrappy in the build-up here, but very decisive in the finish. And Cork lead by 2 points to one.
Yeah, and you saw Bill Cooper there in the build-up and the throw-in, adding that physicality that was missing from their all their team last week. And Bill Cooper, a big, big loss before the game last weekend.
Down it goes towards Aaron Gillan. Got out well ahead of his man, who was Owen Cadigan. Cadigan gave him too much room at that time. And a great score by Gillan.
And this is the one player, I think, that really lights up this attack. What a score. First touch in the Munster Championship, out to the sideline. One little look over his shoulder, and a brilliant point. And he was outstanding last year. Keane Lynch got hurt earlier. He wasn't far behind. I think he dropped his hurl a few times when goals were on. If he'd got them, he would have been the hurler there.
So teams level on a couple of occasions, even in the early stages of this match. But concerned now about Conor Lehan. A foot injury clearly troubling him here. Man who made his championship debut on this ground in 2011 against Galway in a qualifier. He had just finished his leaving cert, and Dennis Walsh, the former manager, brought him in, and it looks like it's a serious injury, and John Myler is going to have to make a change inside the opening 5 minutes. Well, he's a huge loss. He's already scored. Let's see what happened and how it came about here again.
Yeah, he put the ball over the bar just when he fell back here. He just
fell awkwardly.
He was up, you know, there. He didn't realise even himself until he got back up on his feet. And I think, you know, it'll probably be Shane Kingston. I have to say I was bemused by how Shane Kingston could have been left off. I thought last weekend, in the second half in particular against Tipperary, with the needed leaders, he was the man that really stood up and was counted. But here's Lehan going, as you said, for his pace and athleticism, he can blow hot and cold, but a brilliant player on his day.
It's got to be Alan Cadigan who's got to come in.
And that's a big call. He hasn't played much, as John Myler said before the game, and super player on his day as well, but very early stages to be losing a player. Probably would have been looking to spring Cadigan and Kingston later in the second half.
Yeah, it's a big loss, it's a big change. Off goes Lehan, on comes Alan Cadigan. Cadigan coming on for his 17th championship match, but a big disappointment for Conor Lehan to have to leave. From the puck out, Sean O'Donoghue has it. Withstands the challenge, then gets it away downfield towards Aidan Walsh. Beaten for this one by Richie English. Dermot Burns takes it up, diagonally across here. It's a very good ball. Nicely through the hands of Peter Casey. Lets it drop. Has it again. fed in beautifully inside to Graham Mulcahy, and Mulcahy withstands the challenge again and puts it over the bar. Lovely team effort there, all of them involved in the inside forward line once it came diagonally across from Burns.
Yeah, and I think that's what maybe the maturity in Dermot Burns. One time he would have had a go at that, but he picked out a great diagonal ball and Casey to Mulcahy. Mulcahy's at full forward. Cadigan has switched the corner back to man mark Aaron Gillan, who's starting the corner, even though named 14.
That's Robert Downey there getting caught. Dara Fitzgibbon coming to help him out. Big, huge day for the number five for Cork. He's only 19 years of age. Getting bottled up back down there is Sean Finn, forced to kick it out. Picked up here by Luke Mead, trying to link up with a colleague. That colleague was Seamus Harnedy, goal scorer last week. Harnedy pursuing it, looking to try and slip this one over. Umpires have a look at it and wave the white flag. And it's another one for Cork. And it's Seamus Harnedy this time. And the team's level once again at 3 points apiece.
Yeah, and Cork an awful lot hungrier, in my opinion, than they were last week. They're fighting for the 50-50 balls an awful lot harder.
Daniel Carney across there, picked up by Aidan Walsh on a ground where he scored 8 points in an under-21 match. Gives it back to Dara Fitzgibbon, and Fitzgibbon leaves it short into the hands of Nicky Quaid. And Quaid steadies himself, drives it a good 120 metres or more, it seemed, up the field that time. Huge clearance. Back it comes. Carney going back to fetch it. Has a player to give it off to, does so. Gives it out to Mark Coleman. And the 21-year-old from Blarney plays it out there beautifully. Picked up by Alan Cadigan, his first touch. Again, leaving it in confidently and accurately and over. What a start and what a substitution. If it works out for them, Cork lead by 4 points to 3.
Yeah, and you see a lot of the key men involved there. Daniel Carney winning the ball, little ball back to Mark Coleman. He looked up, and that's Cadigan's first touch in a long time at inter-county level. Sean Finn did well initially, but Cadigan held his nerve and a great score.
Cork, as anticipated, looked that little bit more eager than Limerick. Bidding to atone for last week. Batted down well by Dooney, but onto it quickly comes Dara O'Donovan. And then the foul committed. And the referee pointing the finger there towards Mark Ellis. And it's going to be a free for Limerick and a chance for them to level it up once again.
Yeah, Ger, I think a big criticism last week after the match was Tip scored 224 from play, only three frees and a 65. But that could, you could say on one hand that's great discipline from Cork, but on the other hand, is it a lack of aggression, a lack of physicality? I think that was what was, you know, that finger was pointed at the Cork players, and you can see from the start of the game a lot more heavy hits going in and a couple of frees given away, but that's not necessarily a bad thing in the bigger picture.
Aaron Gillan has scored once from play already. This some 55 metres from the target. Wind behind him. And even as I speak, the wind has dropped a little bit, I think. It's straight as you could wish, and a second for Gillan and another for Limerick. So level again. John Kiley, the team manager, under his management, Limerick have won some 26 of the last 33 games. Some record. That's in league and championship. From the puck out here, Dermot Burns lets that one off there as far as Richie English. And then it's taken away by Cork and by Daniel Carney. Back in here to Harnedy, back as far as Bill Cooper. Into open space, but there's nobody there waiting for it. Declan Hannan drops it, recovers, then away off his left-hand side towards Gillan. Drops it again. Wins it back, however. Gillan jinking forward, looking around for a support player. It's Mulcahy, and Mulcahy drills it over the bar. Second for Graham Mulcahy, playing today in his 36th championship match.
Yeah, well, I think Graham Mulcahy last year was hugely important. He got the score that won the All-Ireland for them, but apart from that, he was brilliant all year. But Gillan's awareness again of where he was, lost his hurl, and a little flick hand pass, a lovely score, and a great game so far.
Aidan Walsh trying to win that one, couldn't contain it. In comes Cian Lynch, last year's hurler of the year. About to play it forward, then aware that Walsh was after him, then the challenge was coming in from Coleman as well, left off there towards the wing forward, who is Garrod Hegarty, making a lot of ground, showing his strength, determination, resolution as well. And eventually the referee blows the whistle and it'll be a free for Limerick from the 20-metre line. Great work by Garrod Hegarty.
And exactly as you say, George, pure strength. It's absolute size and strength. But look at the Coleman pulling out of his jersey, trying to stop him. He was half through on goal. I don't think there was any card given. But that's... I think that's Limerick settling into the game. I would have thought, you know, not having had a game, that was an advantage to Cork playing last week. It might take Limerick a little while to settle. So I think they'll be happy after 11 minutes that they should be leading by 2 points now when Gallant taps this over.
And it's also the third free conceded by Cork in their own half. So Gallant ready to roll this one up. The umpires had a little look at that one because it was just inside the right-hand upright, but it counts.
Yeah, just about. No Hawkeye here, so the decision will be made, and that'll be it right or wrong.
6-4, Limerick lead. Blocked down well that time. Great play over there by Peter Casey, younger brother of fullback Mike. Well, it's his big opportunity, of course, and he's the one who keeps Seamus Flanagan out of the starting 15. So an opportunity for him, massive opportunity. He's got to produce, and he's doing well so far. Early stages, 12 minutes in. Coming across to hit this one, Mark Coleman on that wing, left-sided. Great elevation, brilliantly done. All the way inside towards Harnedy, broken down. Aidan Walsh flicking it forward here, taken up by Alan Cadigan, a block on it there by Sean Finn. That's a tasty duel between those two. Inside quickly it comes, this time to Dara Fitzgibbon, battling to try and get away from Hagerty, who was holding on to him and in over the arm as well. So free to Cork will be the outcome, and Patrick Horgan once again will come out here to take this one.
Yeah, and a good call by the ref. Hagerty put in the hand, put it in again, just see that spare arm, and he playing the man. And Dara Fitzgibbon, a brilliant hurler, wouldn't have been happy with the way he played last week. Had a quiet game by his standards, but he's himself and Mark Coleman, two brilliant young players in that Cork team.
He's had a very, very busy year, Michael, as well, Dara Fitzgibbon. That's with the club, Charleville College, of course, UCC, Cork. He was in the All-Ireland Intermediate Club Final, of course. One of the stars of that, scored some 10 points in the final and still lost. Here's Hoggy, as they call him in Cork, and Patrick Horgan drops it over the bar, 2 from 2 for him, and it's back to a one-point game once again. Here comes Kyle Hayes, and Hayes beautifully over. Got into space, got free, got the chance and availed of it. Two between them once more.
Yeah, you saw the hurling brain there. Garrod Hegarty went up, broke the ball, but Hayes had the intelligence to stay down and wait for that. We saw in the last match in Tipham, Waterford going up for the ball a few times, two men and just one man there, great score.
Horgan came across this time to try and win it for Cork, was chasing after it. Instead, it's Dan Morrissey, one of last year's All-Stars for Limerick. And they had many on that All-Star team. Battling to try and win it here is Daniel Carney, out as far as Dara Fitzgibbon. Fitzgibbon striking it down to the inside forward. One man waiting inside there for it, and that's Alan Cadigan, being marked by Sean Finn, and Finn comes out with it, twists and turns, fouled, and the Limerick crowd rise to their feet to salute his efforts. Brilliant defending there by the 23-year-old from Brough.
And I suppose Limerick have two cornerbacks like Sean Finn and Rich English that are hurling cornerbacks. They're tight markers, they're tough and all that, but they're really confident on the ball, and that's a great duel. Cadigan made a brilliant run across the 21 to take up a position there, but covered all the time by Finn. Brilliant defender.
Dermot Burns has got to be the free taker, deep inside his own half. In there dangerously, batted down by Sean O'Donoghue, taken out here by Mark Coleman. Into the shoulder he comes, kicks it away eventually, resourcefully, out as far as Daniel Carney, tried to lay it off, picked up by Kian Lynch instead, flicks it forward, one back by Bill Cooper. Cooper drives it back into the Limerick half of the field, but there's nobody there for it except Sean Finn, who judged it well, had the time, and then able to get it out to Kyle Hayes. But the challenge came in immediately from Daniel Carney, and the referee said there was a foul there, and it's a free to Cork and a chance to make it a one-point game once again.
I often think them low ball along the ground like that, you know, to a big man like Hayes, he wanted that up into his hand, and Daniel Carney in like a flash, that's what he does. He works so hard and he wins the free.
And this man, of course, is the man who got the equalising point in Cork last year in the corresponding match, in an absolutely brilliant match on a Saturday night down in Páirc Uí Chaoimh, which was watched by 35,000 people. Once again, it's going to be Patrick Horgan. When it comes to preparation, well, he's an absolute perfectionist, this man. like all free takers, practice after practice after practice, and now one is just after hitting the top of the upright and gone out wide. So a missed opportunity, Cork's first wide of the game.
I think that's his first wide of the championship, I think, from player frees.
Probably
scored everything against Tipperary.
Declan Hannan providing the fodder inside this time. Touched down by Gillan, one back here in the end by Mark Ellis. Mark, who was standing on the terraces last Saturday, or last Sunday rather, supporting Cork, now suddenly finding himself out there in the middle. Change of direction here as Alan Cadigan tries to jink forward, then cuts back outside Richie English, and the referee's got to bring the ball back and award a free in for a foul there on Cadigan, who, if you joined us late, has come in as a replacement for the injured Connerly Hahn.
Yeah, I think Cork's half-back line, to be fair, you know, while Garrett Hegarty, Kyle Hayes and Tom Morrissey have all been on the ball, their Cork half-back line sending very good ball into a full forward line. There's an awful lot of room up there. Off camera, Patrick Horgan is drawn out the field. He's leaving two men inside, and, you know, Cadigan's pace and Walsh's physicality causing plenty of problems in there.
Well, there were lots and lots of questions asked by Cork supporters about the selection of this team for this match in Limerick. As Patrick Horgan, having missed one, makes sure he doesn't miss another. He's got three out of four. And it's 7 points to six. Anybody's match. Nicky Quaid again with the restart. As ever, Kyle Hayes is his target, but the hand pass was errant. And there was Harnedy to pick it up, back by Aidan Walsh, eventually into Daniel Kearney. And Kearney looking up and seeing it go over the bar, his first point of the match. And he ties up the game once again, and the teams are level for the fifth tie.
Yeah, a little bit of a lack of sharpness there. You saw Kyle Hayes normally, that would have went to hand. He passed it back behind Kyle Hayes, Harnedy onto it, out to Cadigan, and a very good score. I'm not sure what Cork player, I think it's whoever ran into Hayes, big strong man, he was coming back, and just watch here.
Well, that was Bill Cooper, wasn't it?
Yeah, clash of heads there, and that's, I'd imagine he'll have to be taken off for some sort of an assessment. It was a very, very heavy hit.
Well, Cork lost their corner forward, Conor Lehan, shortly after he had scored a point for Cork after 5 minutes with a foot injury. And now concerns about Bill Cooper, the 31-year-old from Yall. Major absentee last week. Well, the physio and the doctors, Dr. Con Murphy was out there to attend to him, along with the physio, who's Rory Bedell. He's okay. Nicky Quaid with the puck out. Towards left half forward this time. It was intended for Tom Morrissey. Kyle Hayes missed it. In there was Garrod Hegarty to try and win it. Held back by Dara Fitzgibbon. Free to Limerick. Taken very quickly. Very, very quickly. And the referee's got to call it back after it was played into the hands of Cian Lynch. And I think if you're Cian Lynch and a Limerick follower, you're a bit disappointed with that.
It was a great take. You know, this happens a lot in hurling. Maybe with puckouts when players aren't outside the 21, or the ref hadn't blown the whistle to restart the play, so it couldn't be taken. But sometimes, you know, I think a quick free should be let go.
Well, it was an absolutely brilliant ball, explained away by Paul O'Dwyer. So it's take two. Once again, Dermot Byrne is going to be the free taker. Right in the centre of the field. He could put it over from here. Seen him do it many, many times. And another white flag. Two from two for Dermot Byrne from those long-range frees. And Limerick in front again. 20 minutes gone. Anthony Nash with the puck out towards Luke Mead. Down into the corner here towards Alan Cadigan. Ran away off his stick. Still trying to attune to the pace of the championship game once again, having been out for such a long time. Missed all of last year's championship. There's John Kiley and Paul Kinnerk there, the team coach from Weir Fórna. And our congratulations to him, as Paul was married a few weeks ago.
Enjoyed the puck out, I think, interesting. Last week, Tipperary forced Cork in the second half in particular to puck the ball out long, and they got cleaned out, Brendan Maher in particular. But today, the movement a lot better at the Cork forwards. They've taken some short ones, but they've picked out Luke Mead there, and Cork doing an awful lot better on their puck outs today than they did last Sunday.
It'll be Darragh O'Donovan who will take this sideline cut. didn't get much elevation or distance into it, so Cork are onto it immediately. O'Donovan trying to make amends back there to help out as Cian Lynch, his midfield ally, up as far as Kyle Hayes, the big tall man, the Kildymo man, as far as Tom Morrissey. Morrissey trying to get away from Sean O'Donovan, trying to hook him. Still good work by Morrissey, but into the corner, and there's nobody fast enough to be able to get to that, and it's a wasted opportunity, and that is wide number two for Limerick. Quick tick puck out all the way down towards Alan Cadigan. Oh dear, just hope he's okay. His momentum was such that he couldn't stop himself, kept on going after this. Plenty of energy, is right. Just hope he's okay at the end of it.
No, he's straight back up. He was very, very lucky, as you say. Again, the quick puck out, the space created. Cadigan's movement, incredible, from side to side. A couple of balls have broken away from him, maybe that he should have controlled, but as we said earlier, he's been out of the game for a long time, but certainly his enthusiasm and movement is outstanding.
That's Tom Morrissey playing this ball across the field here. Kyle Hayes, pursued there by Robert Downey. Hayes, strong, resourceful, puts it ahead of himself, goes after it. Three men in hot pursuit, and it's still Hayes. Back in here beautifully as far as Garrod Hegarty swings on this one. It's going to drop short, however. Anthony Nash to begin the restart for Cork to a two-man inside forward line. Three, four Limerick players there against them. Broken down towards Alan Cadigan. Has Patrick Horgan there in for company. Horgan takes it up, stops at it, and puts it over the bar. That's a brilliant point. Four for Horgan. First three from Freeze.
And if you look there, you have four Limerick defenders all around. A great work rate there by Horgan first. Cadigan then unselfishly could have went for his own score, but gave it to Horgan, the danger man.
Targeted the puck out this time. Garrod Hegarty can't get to it. There's great enthusiasm and eagerness being shown by Cork today. Darragh Fitzgibbon went in for that one. Foul was committed at the end of it, however, and it's got to be a Limerick free.
Yeah, I think Limerick got the free for a throw ball. Cork, I think it was Darragh Fitzgibbon got a slap in the head. Watch here, slap in the helmet. That's a free to Cork. Should have been given, was missed by the referee. And now Limerick getting the free in.
It was Graham Mulcahy who made contact with him. John Myler getting very, very exercised.
This is a different Cork team than we saw in the second half. They were very good in the first half for a long time against Tip, but the second half they went out of the game. Great work by Hayes here. I don't know how he won the ball back there against three Cork men, but he did.
Limerick have the chance to go back in front again. They won a good start to this round robin championship, first of their four matches here in Munster. Brian Geary going in to have a little word with Kyle Hayes. From Cork's point of view, it's a game which they really dare not lose, because they will be on a knife edge at the end of it if they are pointless after two matches. That's the pressure on this man here, John Myler.
Absolutely, but you know, they're going about it the right way. They're not letting Limerick settle anywhere. They're following their men, but particularly up front, their movement, and they're confusing the Limerick defenders, leaving two inside, and the amount of ball that they're winning, Horgan, Cadigan, especially, very, very dangerous. Maybe not getting that many scores from the ball that's going in, and that'll be the only worry that Cork would have.
Gillan again, some 60 metres from the target as the crow flies. And he's hit it just away left, it drifted. And that is wide number three. They stay level at 8 points apiece. 10 minutes to go to half time. As expected, a very even contest between these two very well matched Munster rivals. Jumping there was Aidan Walsh. Again, he puts the stick in, tries to win it back, but fouls his man in the process there, Richie English. Free to Limerick. Dermot Burns preparing to take it. Quick look around to see who's making the runs for him. And the linesman on this near side, who is Shane Hayes from Galway, says, take it back a foot, and he does. Across the field they go. Over to Dan Morrissey. Dan spooning it there as far as Dara O'Donovan. Back into open space. Hegarty has switched wings. Collected here by Declan Hannan. Chance to move forward now and go for a score himself. Leaves it a little bit short, but it's picked up by Mulcahy. And what a goal by Graham Mulcahy! 1-8 to 8 points. 26 minutes are gone. It's his 10th ever championship goal.
Sure, sometimes you need a bit of luck. A miss hit by Declan Hanley. He was going for his own score, but from no angle. What a finish. Absolutely straight into the roof of the net. Give Anthony Nash no chance. And maybe that's what Limerick need. They're a little bit subdued. Brilliant catch by Harnady.
And Harnady sets off. He's got a point already in this match. Leaves it off inside to Walsh. Takes it back. Harnady going in. Oh, stopped on the line. Comes back out to Declan Hanlon. Hanlon trying to get that ball away for Limerick. Cork trying to get it back. Bill Cooper goes in, wins it. Really exciting contest right across the face here. Richie English gets a touch to it, gets it out. Picked up again by Limerick, picked up by Garrett Hagerty this time. Sweeps it forward. One against two inside there. It's Aaron Gillard. Gillard against the two players. Three men go back now. Eventually they win it back, Cork. Taken out here by Owen Cadogan. He's fouled and it's going to be a free out to Cork. What a passage of play.
Deja vu, Ger. Last year's All-Ireland semi-final, Harnady straight through. And Nicky Quaid made that, which now famous save, and the very same thing there. I think it was Quaid came out. We'll see the replay in a second. We're going to have a yellow card here for Garrett Hegarty, and I'd say for Mark Ellis, who followed through afterwards. But what a brilliant movement by Harnady, brilliant 1-2 with Aidan Walsh. But I'm almost certain Nicky Quaid came out and dived in the very same as last year's All Ireland semi-final and flicked the ball away.
And that is still spoken of in many, many places as being the save of the year. So Garrett Hegarty gets a yellow card. And he also dishes out a yellow card here to Mark Ellis, as Michael Dagnan was predicting. So the end result.
Oof, that's high end.
That really was. 1-8-2-8 points.
Here we go here now. Here's Harnady back in. And out comes Quaid. A brilliant flick away. And the ball is cleared in.
And that was at a stage last year where Cork were on top. Had they got that goal, who knows what might have happened. It might have changed the entire history of last year's hurling championship.
Look at this for a finish. Look at the angle. Unbelievable. Like a rocket straight in past. That is an incredible goal.
From the man who got the first of those three goals in the All-Ireland final. And what a crucial goal it was for Limerick as well to settle them down. There had been so many misses that day. They needed some positivity and they needed somebody with a huge amount of experience to come in and do something special. Graham Mulcahy did it there. Mulcahy, who only won one of his first seven championship matches playing for Limerick. And Limerick had the ball again. And it's Cian Lynch this time. Takes too many steps. Free against him. Free to Cork. Cork rocked by the concession of that goal. 3 points the margin. Well, just when John Myler and his coaching team had thought they had tightened things up completely and absolutely, as you mentioned, Michael, there was a degree of luck about it, the way that ball dropped short from Declan Halland's clearance. This one is a long, long one, and it's over the bar. Brilliantly done. So 1-8 now to 9 points, and that's 5 for Horgan.
Yeah, and a lot of talk about the light slitter. You know, that would have been impossible. A 65 was a big score 20 years ago, but that... alone even for the slitter, that is an incredible strike by Horgan. To have the confidence to go out and hit those is just, it's just fantastic what that man can do on a field. As dead balls are from general play.
Out to Kyle Hayes again, drops it down this time. Coleman tries to get to it, instead it is Dara Fitzgibbon. Fitzgibbon hounded, chased it, pursued. Limerick sensing that there might be something if they put in the pressure on the Cork backs. Garrett Hingry, great block that time by Robert Downey. Comes back out again, this time to Graham Mulcahy, and Mulcahy gets another one. A goal and a point for Graham, a goal and 3 points now for Graham Mulcahy. What a first half performance that is.
It is, and brilliant unselfish play by Casey again. And this is what makes Limerick so difficult. There's no egos in that forward line to throw the ball around. The goal was opportunistic, but a brilliant finish. But the points he scored have all been laid on by his colleagues.
Mark Coleman down to Luke Mead. Needs to impact this game. Into Aidan Walsh. Operating mostly around the middle of the field. That's beautifully up as far as Aaron Gillan, but Gillan hold on, can't hold on to it because they were holding him back. And it's going to be a free-in instead.
As you can see, Jonathan, I think the last few minutes, Limerick coming to terms with the pace of the game. There might have been a little tug back. Gillan went down easy enough, but... it's just in the last 3 or 4 minutes their tackling, their work rate, their hooking, their blocking, particularly of their forwards, has been up to gear, and you can see that being reflected. Cork holding in there at the moment, but Limerick really pressing hard now.
So Daniel Carney has got himself a yellow card, and he is the second Cork player to be booked by the referee. So a straightforward opportunity then for Aaron Gillan to knock this one over. Got that exquisite goal in the league final against Waterford. Drives it over here, happy just to take his point. Early stages in this match. Just about 3.5 minutes to go to half-time, and Limerick lead by 110 to 9 points. Cork hoping now not to allow Limerick expand that lead in any way, shape or form. They need to cut into it quickly. Aidan Walsh, two men after him. Back as far as Carney it comes. Daniel Carney, nippy as ever, enthusiastic as ever, wins a free 20 metres out. And a chance for Patrick Horgan from what will be a tight angle to make it a one-score game once again. Richie English there from Doon, left corner back. He's had a very good match so far, along with Sean Finn and the rest of the fullbacks. Limerick have conceded 6 frees so far in this match, and Horgan coming up to try and put another one over the bar. Well, it's wayward this time. That's the second one he missed. It wasn't an easy one. The earlier one that he missed was, I think, just a little bit nearer. Nicky Quaid. Kian Lynch poised to jump for this one, but beaten for it this time. Broken down instead. And Cork are able to mount their next attack. Inside towards Alan Cadigan. Back to Horgan. Change of direction. Picking it up here is Seamus Harnady. And Harnady has put this one inside the left-hand upright. He's got his second point. And it's a goal difference once again, 110 to 10 points.
Yeah, and we praise the Limerick interplay up front. Very same there. Cadigan, Horgan, unselfish, and picked out Harnady, who's in support. And he's a lot livelier today as well. Much better performance overall by Cork than we saw last week. Much hungrier, much more aggressive, and playing more as a team.
Peter Casey there, beaten for that one by Niall O'Leary, who's keeping a very, very tight rein on him. So line ball coming up. It'll be Dara O'Donovan who will take it. Got 3 points in 2 matches against Cork last year. One of 10 scorers in the All-Ireland final, this time chipping it in. Cork win it back, however. And just as it has been taken out there by Dara Fitzgibbon, he was taken down. Rather blatant foul. Teams tend to do that to make sure that their defences get an opportunity to get organised for the next attack. And very often the players who are the offenders get away with it without cards.
Yeah, and we saw Tipperary last week fouling a lot in the first half. They came out in the second half, didn't foul. Eight frees in the first half last week. Horgan scored all 8 in the second half, then they changed that. But that can work. It maybe softens up a few tackles going in, softens up some of the forwards. And Patrick Horgan, you know, dangerous man to be giving away a freeze, even from this distance.
This is a huge distance, as you say, Michael. It's a good 70 metres. And it's another one that has gone away left. Yeah, we couldn't miss last week. He's missed 3 today.
Yeah, we put the commentator's curse on him this week. Very, very unlike him.
Everybody expects the free takers to always be able to put them over, irrespective of the distance, but they have a lot of responsibility on their shoulders. Limerick right now have possession back, and it's Tom Morrissey feeding it in towards Aaron Gillan. Peter Casey beaten for that one by Niall O'Leary, who came across, timed his intervention perfectly, and got that ball away with the help of Owen Cadigan. He's not getting it easy, Peter Casey, in there with Niall O'Leary, keeping tabs on him.
Yeah, lively player, but power of Flanagan, you know, big asset as well, and we'll see him at some stage.
Yeah, he got 5 points against Cork in Porky Creek last year. That's a great catch by Mike Casey, beautifully taken down into Dara O'Donovan. Up it goes again towards the danger man inside. And Aaron Gillan, this time deemed to have committed the offence himself. And the free goes against the Limerick man.
This is Sean Finn's catch earlier. I don't think that was a free. I think Gillan was behind his man, but he got his hand to it. He's just trying to get out to the ball there. I don't see any free. They're having a fair tussle in there. We saw Cadigan had the job of marking Shane McCallum for a lot of the game last Sunday as well.
I think Cork were lucky to get the free there, as you say. Anthony Nash takes it. A player who's got 3 goals and 12 points in the championship in the past himself. Into Harnady, and Harnady, quick as you like, puts it over. And he's now got 3. And Cork have got another, and it's 1-10 to 11 points. It's a 2-point game approaching half-time.
And Seamus Harnady scored 1-2 last week, but wasn't in the game. He got a point early on, got a great goal, but today he's way more influential at centre-half forward.
Cork a lot more driven this time. Dara Fitzgibbon, 2 men in support. One of them is Bill Cooper. Has another man to his right there. It was Daniel Carney, but they battled for it and the pass broke down. And it was Darren O'Donovan who got it out there as far as Graham Mulcahy, who came out to midfield to help out. A wayward pass then eventually picked up here, and Cork go forward again. And it's Daniel Carney who goes down under the weight of the challenge. And I think the Limerick fans now are beginning to say, hang on, he was falling down that time.
Right, watch here, he went to ground. There was a hand in there, but he went to ground. He was going to ground. And I just think from both sets of view and from a neutral point of view, an awful lot of frees. You know, Todd Ware seems to have gone whistle happy in the last 7 or 8 minutes, but to me, again, lucky enough, he was heading to the ground the minute he got the ball.
About 2 minutes remaining of the added time. So this can make it a 1-point game. Having missed 3, pressure now on Patrick Horgan. 5 points in the first half, and now he's back into his stride again with his 6th. Limerick 1-10, Cork 12 points, 13-12 in points. Nicky Quaid from Effin, going left half forward this time. It rolls and it stays in play. Tom Morrissey did well, but Robert Downey trying to keep tabs on him. Picked up eventually here and away by Niall O'Leary. Down into the middle of the park as far as Seamus Harnady. Too many Limerick players there, however, when that ball ran loose. And Darrell O'Donovan's able to easily pick out Kian Lynch. Plays it in beautifully. Oh, it was intended for Hagerty. Garroyd Hagerty was the one forward in there against 2 or 3 Cork backs. Cork in numbers. They get it out to Daniel Carney. Held onto by Fitzgibbon. Dara Fitzgibbon rolled too far that time. Intended for Luke Mead. Beat him, however, easily. Mike Casey instead. Up as far as Hagerty again, drops into the goalkeeper's hands, and the referee has blown his whistle and decides that Garroyd Hagerty was being held unfairly, and it's a free in for Limerick. Late opportunity of another score.
You watch here, Mark Coleman is just holding out his man. To me, again, that's no free. You don't let the full forward in on top of your goalkeeper. Bad decision. Mike Casey, I think it was his first puck of the ball before that, but just go back before that. Keane Lynch got the ball, a simple chance to put over the bar, but like all the great players, he spotted Hegarty inside. The ball was maybe a yard too high even for Hegarty. If it went to hand, it was a goal. So Cork got out of jail there, and now Limerick being, I think, handed a very, very soft free straight in front of the goal.
Well, whatever about the legitimacy of the free itself, it means that Cork have now conceded 9 frees in scorable positions to Limerick during this first half. They're on the line just in case. Aaron Gillan did the wise thing, puts it over, his 5th. So now it's 1-11 to 12 points, 2 between them, and the referee's about to blow for half time here. Teams were level several times during the opening 15 minutes, but then in the 26th minute, it was a particularly important moment for Limerick. Declan Hannan free, which dropped short to Graham Mulcahy, and he finished quite expertly beyond Anthony Nash. Just as I'm watching here now, I think John Myler is going out to have a word with the referee, and I don't think he's too pleased with some of the decisions that have gone against his team in the opening 35 minutes. But it's all to play for. Just a couple of points between them. Mike Reardon's out there as well for Limerick, having some words. There's the halftime score anyway. Limerick 1-11, Cork 12 points. We're back with analysis right after this.
Okay. It has been a rip-roaring opening half at the Gaelic grounds. Limerick in front, 111 to 12 points. So much happened in that opening half that Anthony Daly was wondering if we could request a 45-minute halftime because there's so much to talk about. There was loads of drama in Parnell Park, by the way, as well. Sean Moran scored a goal for Dublin at the very, very end of the match to snatch a draw between Dublin and Wexford. So it's still very much so all to play for in Leinster, but it is in Limerick as well in this Munster Championship game. Questions all week since last weekend, Páirc Uí Chaoimh, about how Cork were structured. So, have they improved?
Definitely, Joanne. I think we saw loads of examples of how Cork were better structured and better organised and better going forward. We saw Mark Coleman coming more into the game. Alan Cadigan, since he came on, it was a big blow to lose Conor Lehan so early in the game. But Cadigan's movement has been excellent up front. It was a criticism of Cork last week that their movement was poor in attack. But what I like here is, watch Mark Coleman, watch him in here, OK? In terms of, and Owen Cadigan having extra men back and covering. Like, that's the way you need to defend against this team. Another example of it, you see all the Cork players conscious of that space between themselves and the full-back line. And you actually have a 2-on-1. And Cork did really well. This is the type of team, because Limerick withdraw so much, they're actually struggling at times in that they don't have too many players
compared
inside.
To the goals from last week as well.
Exactly.
Well, so, pivotal to that is Daniel Carney, I think, and Bill Cooper being back as well. Like, Daniel Carney is covering so much ground, and that's why Cork put it up to him last year. Those two players were very much part
and
of
Darragh Fitzgibbon and Darragh Fitzgibbon and Coleman way up on
that's it. Yeah. And we flagged that before the game. Like, everybody, these guys know how to play the game. Their management know how to manage the game. But it's key that you're actually doing these things. How many times did we see Daniel Carney? He's probably not half the size of Kyle Hayes, but that's the type of spirit that you need.
They're playing for their manager.
You're hunters.
They're playing for their manager.
Yeah, exactly. That's what the type of spirit that you need from your half forwards. They are hunters. They're the guys that are coming out and not allowing fellas like Kyle Hayes get ball with nobody around them.
And it could be very frustrating for Limerick, and I'm sure it was, but they stuck to that game plan, didn't they?
Well, that's it. Like, they just joined. They're very structured. They like to play a certain way. They allow the shot puck out, but they'll stick to it. And Declan Hannan loves to come forward, you know, seize the ball inside. Not probably maybe going for a point, but like Graham Mulcahy, razor sharp. Finally get on a one-on-one and he sticks it.
But this, just from the puck out then, Seamus Harney, captain's part, wins that ball. He knows Cork need a big score. 1-2 with Aidan Welsh. Like this semi-final, steps inside. Nicky Quaid was very brave. Very similar to that incident last year, the dying embers of the All-Ireland semi-final. But to be fair, that was Cork. The difference in Cork, they responded very, very well with that opportunity.
Any question marks over goalkeeping here, Donalogue? Everybody, a lot of people will say beating at his near post.
No, I tell you, I know from a goalkeeper, there's a lot of bull spoken about this near post thing, right? Like, no way, not a hope.
That was the way it was a speed he struck it.
Exactly.
Like, the ball was gone past him before he
and
even
he stands up. Like, the key thing in a position like that is that you are standing up and making yourself as big as possible. I guarantee you, umpire, probably Anthony, you wouldn't even see that going over the head there.
Now, there was this brilliant battle, and it's right in front of us here between Owen Cadigan and Aaron Gillan. And Cadigan has been getting on top, but we could see that in around that area that Limerick did have this chance at the end.
Yeah, look, we highlighted it last week on the Sunday game, and for a couple of seconds we thought that this was going to be almost like a repeat of it. For some reason, Cork did lose their bearings. They've been outstanding for most of the second half. I think even, you know, Anthony Nash was more advanced, was good, but I love this here. Mark Coleman, composure, getting back, picking the ball off the ground and hand passing it back.
Well, hold on. What vision off Keane Lynch as well.
Oh, yeah,
and just slightly overcooked the ball inside.
But it was Mark Coleman actually lost him. Mark Coleman was marking him, and he did identify, to be fair, and he did make the yardage to get back.
And there's been a couple of examples of that. Like that fast free that was taken by Limerick, that would have been one of the moments of the year. Like, I would have thought that should have been left go because it was such a precision.
That's the only little Pod is doing his best. He's up with it. Couple of little fussy frees I would have thought near the end there, especially Sam Mark Coleman's last one. Daniel Carney as well, one above. Like, I didn't really think that was a free. But this is back to the stuff of last year.
Exactly. This is championship. It's got a championship feel. We can hear the crowd here roaring beside us. Like, all of the blocking, hooking, all of that stuff. I know we all like to talk about tactics. We like how the game is played and understand it. But this is Munster Championship what we're looking at here.
Yeah, it has had absolutely everything in the first half, and I'm sure we can expect more of the same in the second. It's coming up next. in June, starting on Friday the 7th. It's the FIFA Women's World Cup with every game live, free to air on RTÉ and TG Cahir. Here at the LIT Gaelic Grounds, it's Limerick in front of Cork by 2 points. In that opening half, we're so used to seeing Limerick be slick all of the time. Were a few of their touches off, did you think?
Yeah, I think so. We're just commenting again at half-time about that. I just think they haven't played a championship match yet, so they were just spilling the ball a little bit. I think it was Cork's intensity, you know. They didn't have the time, the opportunity to get on it. But, you know, it's been a humdinger of a match. Just looking at some of the stats there. So basically, both teams have 18 shots, 12 scores each. Same efficiency. Puck outs, Limerick of 64%. Cork are in 60%, so there's very, very little between the two of them, and it's going to be very hard to call.
They drew twice last year,
yeah,
as well.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
There's extra time that separated them.
So what might swing it then?
The one thing about Cork today, and I do think, we spoke a lot about this today, I think Cork strategically are conscious of their bench, and I do think that they left Cadogan, Kingston and Flynn off it with a reason, and the reason being with 10-15 minutes to go here today that you could offload them. And even if you compare that to last year's championship game, it was a much different story when Cork looked around to their bench.
Have you seen Limerick's bench though?
They have Shemi Flanagan coming too.
Yeah.
And I think if I'm Kylie in there, I'm saying the league is over, boys. You know, you won the National League pulling up. That's over. This is championship. You've seen it out there, the belting you're getting, the little time you have. And maybe, just maybe, Limerick might adjust to the pace now. Cork have the game under their belt last week and came ready really to battle, you know, really obviously hurt by you know, the way they were written off at home and by commentators like myself and stuff like that. But just, I think you might see Limerick now getting up to the pace. But I haven't a clue really, Joanne. Is that tight?
Well, it is that kind of one. And we see John Myler coming out there, and we saw him having a go at Paul O'Dwyer.
Well, I think it was that instance, a couple of instances just before half time. There was two soft enough. Cadogan was blue for one, Mark Coleman was blue for one. They were very dubious awarded frees for Limerick.
And Limerick could say the same the other way earlier.
And he was getting it from both sides, I think. So basically, but it's just that tight of a margin. But Harnady has been excellent for, you know, it's a pity Lahan went off so early, but Harnady has been excellent, 3 points from play. Someone like him, he's a captain. It's that leadership now. Their backs are to the wall, but they're in with a good chance.
Yeah, it's interesting. We're looking at
Stephen McDonnell. He's on for Sean O'Donoghue.
I wonder, was that... to be honest, I was looking at Cork full back line and they were holding their own.
Sean O'Donoghue, Graham Mulcahy, won three from play, so, and that's his man. Defend for us.
At the end of the day, that's spoken like the way my mother would say it. What did your man score?
Well, there, a whole lot. That's what he scored, Graham Mulcahy. OK, it's all to play for in this second half. Back to Michael and Ger.
Thanks, Joanne. Yes, both teams back out. Cork, it's the 100th anniversary this weekend of Cork wearing their famous red. They were wearing blue up to the year 1919.
They look happy bringing what mother said about their sons into the equation here. My mother said, I don't care if you win as long as you play well.
So Stephen McDonnell on in place of Sean O'Donoghue, the only change at the start of the second half. And immediately it is Daniel Carney. Not quite as far as he was intending to put that one. Aidan Walsh has certainly put in a Trojan effort so far in this game. Worked tirelessly during the opening 35 minutes. The number 15 for Cork. And there's a problem here for one of the Limerick players. And that looks to be Richie English. Or is it? Yes, it is English. Ooh. Collided there with Alan Cadogan. So being attended to, as you can see at the moment, and a bit of a worry for John Kiely, who's had his half-time talk now. Alan Cunningham there to his right-hand side, part of the backroom team. Richie English, whose dad, Paddy, very sadly passed away about 6 weeks ago. A little bit of rain coming down here now, maybe more than a little bit of rain. Such a beautiful morning in Limerick, lovely sunshine. But those followers over there in the open stand, well, they're going to get the rain that's coming in off the Clare Mountains at this stage, the Clare Hills. Nicky Quaid takes this. All the way down. Collected in here by Graham Mulcahy. Back out as far as Darragh O'Donovan. Broken up and first possession here for Stephen McDonnell, playing his 27th championship. He's lost it to Tom Morrissey. Comes back out again, this time to Kyle Hayes. Slipping it forward here. Change of direction here by Peter Casey, through the shoulders and put the ball wide at the end of it all. Fourth wide.
The rain is going to make it very difficult because it has been so dry. It's going to make it very slippy on surface. Lovely feet there by Casey. He has great balance. It'll suit him. And sluggish start to the second half.
That puck out by Cork, cut out, and Limerick have it again. And looking to press home their advantage now here. The stylish Tom Morrissey puts it to the left. And another missed opportunity. Untypical of them, but they're still finding their stride, I think. That's three wides. From this puck out, let's see what happens. Alan Cadigan's come out to meet it. Takes it away from Sean Finn, who's pursuing him. Back to Luke Mead, and Luke Mead gets the opening point of the second half.
Well, that's
it's
great.
It's what I think he needed.
It is indeed. He was quiet in the first half. But Cadigan, look at the little hand pass here. He slipped it to him. Good movement by Mead to create the space and a very tidy score.
Quaid again. Down to left half forward this time. Runs on. Out was coming Niall O'Leary. Ball collided off his stick, and it's going to be a line ball for Limerick.
Limerick struggling a bit with their puck outs, Ger, in that first half. They only won 7 out of 15. You know, normally Nicky Quaid's puck outs. Brilliant and a huge part of their game plan. But there's another one very close to the sideline and lucky to get the line ball there.
It'll be Darragh O'Donovan who will take it. We've seen him put over sideline pucks. It's a little bit too far out for that one. So another one has gone astray at the start of the second half. And it's still 1-11 to 13 points for Cork. So a one-point difference. Anthony Nash, the Kenturk man, on a ground where he won a Munster Club medal with Kenturk some years ago. To Alan Cadigan, slipping it beautifully in his stride and beautifully over the bar. Playing so well. A second point for Alan Cadigan. Well, the man who thought he probably might get 20 minutes if he was lucky, he's getting most of the match and he's making an impact, and the teams are level. Level once again. Kian Lynch raiding. Dangerous track there by Niall O'Leary, and the referee has blown his whistle and it's going to be a free in. But Kian Lynch, when he drifts forward like that almost unnoticed from midfield, he is so dangerous.
Well, his first touch is just so good. He just doesn't miss the ball, and that was a great pick up on a slippery ball. Could have tapped it over the bar. I thought maybe unnecessarily took on Niall O'Leary there, but won the free, a little tug on the sleeve.
Well, it's going to be a chance now for Aaron Gillan, once he has dried the hurley and make sure the grip's okay, to put Limerick back in front again. Certainly rated the most in-form hurler in the country at the end of March. Brilliant league campaign. This an easy one for him, you would imagine. Just outside the 20-metre line. No mistake.
An interesting to see the next puck out here. The last two from Anthony Nash, long ball straight down the middle, and both of them went over the half-back line and straight into Alan Cadigan to control both of them. Limerick have to get under that puck out, and they've been drawn out of position by the Cork half-forward line at the moment.
It's a long one again, and it was Aidan Walsh who was targeted. It runs by, however, as far as Daniel Carney. Slip back to Alan Cadigan, and Cadigan, who looks to be really in form this time, misses the target, not by much. It's a fourth wide. Referee, is he bringing back the play? I think he is. It's Daniel Carney who's receiving the attention anyway, so maybe it was an advantage that the referee had been allowing that time. So it's now going to be an opportunity for Cork and for Patrick Horgan to add to the 6 points that he got in the opening 35 minutes. Had his misses then, and he's had another one here. Hard to believe it.
Yeah, very, very unusual. That's four frees now Patrick Horgan has missed. Normally, Cork could be leading this match by a couple of points, and Limerick not playing well and still leading the game.
Kyle Hayes holding off the challenge there of Mark Coleman, playing it in here, bounces off the shoulder of Peter Casey to his marker, Niall O'Leary. And then Casey goes back and hooks him to win it back. Shows great industry. Out it comes to Bill Cooper. Has a man in support on his right-hand side. And he was trying to get it there to Daniel Carney. But in nipped Dan Morrissey. And the referee had blown his whistle by then. A puzzle-looking Dara O'Donovan looks back at the official. It's going to be a free to Cork, and it's Patrick Horgan once again is coming out to take it.
Yeah, that's great play by Niall O'Leary. He goes out. Watch here, Casey follows him out. That's a feature of Limerick when they're going well. We've only seen maybe patches of it today.
And he hadn't even his stick at the end of it there.
No, he'd great work rate. And I suppose, when you have Seamus Flanagan, Shane Dowling, these lads sitting on the bench, David Dempsey, you're going to either perform or you're going to be gone.
Rain is still spilling down here now. Horgan needs to clear his head of those misses from earlier on. The umpires are looking at it. They're a little uncertain. There's no Hawkeye. The Limerick backs are trying to encourage them to wave it wide, but the referee has made the umpires mind up, and the teams are level for the eighth time, thanks to Patrick Horgan's seventh point of the game. 112 to 15 points. We're in the 43rd minute. Who's going to win it? Long way to go. Stephen McDonald comes out. Eventually it went off the Cork stick there, the stick of Hoggy or Horgan, and it's going to be a line ball for Limerick. Dara O'Donovan will take it. Well, he's got changes in his locker if he wants to make some alterations, that's for sure. That's a miss hit there by Dara O'Donovan. Conditions probably not helping him. Mark Ellis goes back. Player whose last start in the championship for Cork, or in any match for Cork, was last year against Limerick in Porkeycueve, and that was the beginning of June. Patrick Horgan again. Late challenge on him as he hit that ball away. The referee, I don't think, saw it, and it's gone wide. Yeah. The Limerick player came into his back immediately after he hit it. Puck out anyway has been taken as far as Mike Casey. Down there towards Tom Morrissey, struggling to keep the ball in play. A little bit too difficult in the end.
Yeah, I just think Limerick trying to play the ball very, very tight to the sideline. It's backfiring on them. The ball is breaking out over the line. They're not controlling it. And, I think maybe with the size they're having, maybe more direct ball down the middle, a couple of them just to let the ball break from there and get onto the breaking ball. But at the moment, they're not getting any possession, and Cork, I think, would be amazed that they're only level. That, they should be a few points ahead, but Patrick Horgan's radar are slightly out today.
Well, they're using boxes and anything at all that will help to try and keep the rain off the heads. Mark Coleman ready to cut it up. Gets good distance in it, down as far as Seamus Harnedy, the East Cork player. Across here, little touch on it there by Daniel Carney. In it goes to Horgan again. Horgan beats two attempted blocks, gets it up over his right shoulder, and more importantly, gets it over the crossbar. He's got an eighth.
It just shows you the confidence this man has. He's just after having a wide from play, he's missed four frees, but still just shortened up the grip there and straight over the bar.
Nobody was marking Kyle Hayes from the quick puck out. Back to Dan Morrissey. Concentration so important for all of these players. Back in by Tom Morrissey. Nicely inside here to the goal scorer, Graham Mulcahy. And Mulcahy puts it over. First score of the second half. That's a goal and four for him now. Really good work.
Yeah, he's a real leader of this team. He gets so many important scores and, not going well. They needed a score there, and Mulcahy delivers again.
So level again. Nine times now they've been level in this fabulous match. Up here well by Aidan Walsh, hasn't scored so far, but he's contributed handsomely into Daniel Carney, and Carney puts it over. It's now become a shootout, as expected, and as we had twice last year when these teams battled in the championship.
But Aidan Walsh's role is crucial, Jerry. He's getting under the puck out, he's bringing Richie English out under the puck out instead of Dan Morrissey. I don't know why Dan Morrissey doesn't go up for the ball and leave Richie English down to pick up the breaks, but the role of Walsh has been brilliant. He's using the ball, winning every ball and using it brilliantly.
There's been a yellow card for Aaron Gillard. Owen Cadigan plays it out, helped away. That ball drops short. Nicky Quaid controls calmly out to his right-hand side as far as Dermot Burns, pursued there by Seamus Harnedy. The greasy surface making it awkward for all of the players. Dara O'Donovan now two after him. Knocks it down into space, but there's nobody in a Limerick shirt racing with him. So it's going to be a line ball to Cork again. Both sets of supporters playing their part in a memorable match at Limerick.
But it'll be interesting to see, to me, if Limerick stick to their tactics. That's what they do. They play the ball out of defence. They play the short ball across the middle lateral. It's not working for them today. Cork are hunting in packs. I think Limerick need to go a bit more direct. Mulcahy is on fire inside. Galan is getting very little ball. He's dangerous, but they're not getting it into them.
And Coleman's played a beauty in there to the edge of the D. It's knocked down there as far as Daniel Carney, who's got to make it three. Great work by the 29-year-old from Sars, whose brother William has, or twin brother William, has been part of the squad as well. 113-2, now 18 points for Cork.
Yeah, and a huge part of Cork's success last season, or you know, getting as far as they did, winning Munster, is the role of Carney at wing forward. He had to go midfield when Cooper didn't start against Tipperary. It was a big loss from the half forward line with his work rate and his scoring. 3 points from playing out from Carney.
First time of the match that Cork have led by 2 points. Owen Cadogan stumbles. Aaron Gillan's able to profit, trying to set something up. It reaches Kian Lynch going forward. Still Kian Lynch. The heat was taken out of it when the blocks came in there, and Kian Lynch will have to satisfy himself and Limerick with a free-in instead. He was being chased there by Mark Ellis. A couple of sticks, made contact, made sure there was no clean shot on target. So a chance to make it a one-pointer once again.
Yeah, his incredible hands. The take there, the ball broke. I don't know how he took possession of it so quickly, and he was in on goal. He gets forward, as you mentioned earlier in the commentary, he gets forward from midfield. He ghosts in behind, but that was just, again, brilliant hands and brilliant first touch from Kian Lynch.
A little bit of concern here in picture, as you can see, for 19-year-old Robert Downey playing his first match. Hope we don't call him Robert Downey Jr. Mix him up with the film star who's in the cinemas at the moment. Tense crowd looking on here. I think we said it's over 30,000 here at the LIT Gaelic grounds for this match. Limerick's first, Cork second in this Munster round robin. Aaron Gillan will take it. Just pop it over the bar. Another for him at seven. So now Limerick, 114, that's 18 points. They're happy. Cork, 18 points. Cork just shading it. From the next puck out. In over the head that time of Dan Morrissey. Collected by Aidan Walsh. And not for the first time, but given away. Kian Lynch there to get there ahead of Daniel Carney. Back out it comes to Dara O'Donovan. The two centre-field players working in tandem. Down it goes towards Peter Casey inside that 65-metre line. Pile up of bodies there. Finally coming out, trying to win it, is Luke Mead. Went back and helped. Good work by Luke Mead. That's a great pass by him. Out to Daniel Carney. Slinging it forward. Two men near the 20-metre line for Cork. Three for Limerick. Finally coming out of trying to come out was Mike Casey. He's lost it. Pressure being applied. Richie English goes in. Helped out this time by Sean Finn. Tenacious defending. It had to be tenacious. It had to be courageous.
And sure, that might be the pass to the play, maybe, that gets Limerick going. Mike Casey won a great ball there, 50-50 ball with Patrick Corrigan. And it took bravery and guts from Finn there to come out and drive out that ball and win the free. But watch again the puck out, the previous puck out. Aidan Walsh over Richie English. It's something they've been working on throughout the game. It's working really, really well. Brilliant take, and Carney popping up on the far side of the field again.
Dermot Burns to launch the next attack. It spills from Mark Coleman's fingers. Stephen McDonald goes back, missed last year's championship when he was away, and he's given a very short pass, and it could very nearly end up on the back of the Cork net, and they did very well to get away with that one. Mark Coleman out to Luke Mead. Driven in by Bill Cooper. Towards Patrick Horgan. Horgan scores. Patrick Horgan has just got his 14th ever championship goal. They're celebrating because Cork are leading by four.
And that's a brilliant goal. It started by Mark Coleman. A brilliant ball out to Luke Mead. Up the field. Look at the touch by Horgan. We talked about his wides. Just a brilliant. Kept the eye on the ball. One look into the corner net. Genius at work. 1-2 from play. And forget the missed freeze now.
Problems now for Limerick to address. They nearly scored a goal at the other end. They conceded one instead. And now Cian Lynch comes down, blocked by Mark Coleman. Lynch goes again. Coleman, the referee, blows his whistle and brings the play back. Great excitement. Great drama. This is Horgan. Kept cool, kept calm, and slotted it in past Nicky Quaid. 118 to 114.
Yeah, good response by Limerick though. Kyle Hayes, who's been quiet, very quiet so far in the game, won a good ball there. He was dragged down. I think the referee, you know, getting the calls right, but yellow cards, so that's cynical fouling, a bit of it on both sides, being led away with it. And we've substituted now for Cork. It looks like Christopher Joyce coming in as well.
Christopher Joyce is coming on for Robert Downey. Well, he's got abundant experience. Now it's Aaron Gillan. 4 points down, this to make it three. Just a goal between the teams again, with his eighth. It's still anybody's match. A game which Cork people will feel their team has to win. Limerick want to win, but they'll have three more matches after this. Loose ball picked up by Declan Hannan. Away to his wing back, Dermot Burns. Drops it far, far too far forward. There was nobody in the corner there waiting for it, and Anthony Nash is able to begin the next attack, or trying to. Knocked down by Burns, Hagerty collecting it. All the way back as far as Dan Morrissey. Into O'Donovan. Change of direction, about to be hooped there by Aidan Walsh. And instead of a Limerick attack, it suddenly becomes Mark Coleman picking it up. Across once again it goes. Over here as far as Christopher Joyce, his first contribution, all the way down. Two against three. Two Cork forwards, three Limerick attackers. Alan Cadogan striking it, and Alan Cadogan has put it over the bar. What a performance by Cadogan.
Yeah, and you just see, I think Limerick, you know, running out of ideas. Jared played a couple of balls across the half back line, middle of the field there, and looked up, no movement inside, no one to aim for, and the ball breaks down. And on the other hand, Cork much slicker, much quicker with the ball, the long diagonal ball, and Cadogan and Horgan going to town in the second half.
19, Seamus Flanagan is on. Bill Cooper. Dropping it across here. Was it out? They thought so. Luke Mead didn't. Kept working. Got it into Dara Fitzgibbon. Pursued there by Dara O'Donovan. All the way up towards Horgan. Broke off his stick. Aidan Walsh. What a match he's playing. Out to Harnedy, who's got three in the first half, and he's got another one. And this is a very hot spell for Cork. And a very tricky spell for Limerick. But there's still 15 minutes to go. 5 points the margin.
Yeah, but the movement of the Cork forwards is absolutely destroying Limerick at the moment. The Limerick backs on a hooter marking. Luke Mead, Daniel Kearney, Harnedy, Aidan Walsh, Horgan, Cadogan, all flying it, playing as a team. Another chance here for Cadogan, or for
Daniel Kearney. Missed this time. Well, this was a team that was roundly criticised in Cork after last Sunday's inept performance, as many people saw it, against Tipperary. Playing at home, beginning of the championship, and they gave this very lackluster showing over the 70 minutes. Today, different type of team. And Limerick are being pressurised right, left and centre. That time Kyle Hayes losing possession, out over the sideline, line ball to Cork.
Yeah, look, I was in Cork last Sunday. Cork didn't play anything like this with the same intensity. Their backs were to the wall today, and they have produced big time. But Limerick, I think, really helped them. Their puck-out strategy not working at all for me. Any ball they are winning, they're running out towards the sideline with it. I think they need to go a bit more direct. And, you know, Shane Dowling coming in here now for Gareth Hegarty, great forward. But if you look out in the field, the shape of them, they've only got two forwards up front, and you can withdraw like it worked last year. But this year and today, it's not working. So you have to be able to go to a plan B. And I don't see any sign of that plan B so far.
Well, the big guns have come in. Seamus Flanagan and Shane Dowling. And surely now, if they get possession, they'll make a difference. Mark Coleman. Dangerously in. Collected there by Declan Hannan, the captain. Out to Dan Morrissey. Down it goes towards Gillan. trying to hold it, trying to bring the others into the play then. Back it goes. A real belter from Kyle Hayes, but it was indirect. Away to the right-hand side, and a missed opportunity. He scored just once. Nash again. Into a bunch of players there. Harnedy got a little touch to it. Coming out of it, however, is Alan Cadigan. Away to Harnedy again. Pursued by two players. Dropped short. Nicky Quaid. Back out smartly as far as Dermot Burns. We're in the 58th minute. Niall O'Leary wins this race for possession with Seamus Flanagan. First tussle between the two of them. Back out to Luke Mead. Looking to add to the point he got in the earlier stages of this match. And he's done that. Two for Mead. And now it's 121 to 115. 6 points the margin. And the referee is going back. And he's speaking with Seamus Flanagan. And just moments after coming on, he's going to see a yellow card.
Yeah, in proper order. It was Daniel Kearney won a great ball there, and Flanagan came out with a high tackle. But Kearney, he might be small, but how strong, took the tackle. Ref played the advantage, slipped it to Luke Mead, and a great score.
Ellis is beaten in the air this time by the very tall Kyle Hayes. Forced out over the line, however. Line ball to Limerick it will be.
Gerard, this is obviously a strategy that Limerick had. That we're going to identify weakness in the two wing backs and put the ball out to the sideline. It's not working. Even balls at the wing are going out over the line, and Cork have read it like a book, and Limerick haven't changed. They'd be much better off directing that puck out down the middle to Kyle Hayes. Let him catch it there and create something from there.
Well, let's see if they will do that. Darragh Donovan again misses it. He can hit it straight away himself if he wanted to. But instead it's Cork who emerge with it, and it's Darragh Fitzgibbon. Well, whatever about was being said beforehand about the team and their attitude and whether they were playing for the cause and for the management and all the rest of it, they are fired up this afternoon. No question about that.
The Cork always have good hurlers. This Cork team is very, very talented. And when they play like this, they're very hard to beat. When they play like they did last Sunday, they're very easily beaten. It's just down to attitude, commitment, determination on the day. And you cannot fault this Cork performance today. From 1 to 15, they've lost a couple of players through injury. The players have come in, have been outstanding. And this man coming back to take the free. A lesser man would have dropped ahead. He missed a few frees he'd normally score. Put it behind him. Has scored a goal in two from play. And still willing to come on and take the responsibility from, what are we talking about, well over 100 yards.
Patrick Horgan. Goal at eight. That one has gone to the left. Well, a six-point difference, and they might just be concerned about history, because you remember last year there were also 6 points in front, and you know what happened? Happened in the All-Ireland semi-final. Went to extra time. It won today. That's taken neatly there by Owen Cadigan. Up towards his younger brother, Alan, who's a teacher in Rochestown College. Here's Nicky Quaid, who's also a teacher. Towards Tom Morrissey, one in the air by Mark Coleman, easily given off there as far as Patrick Horgan, and Horgan challenged as he was hitting that one, but misses in any case. It stays as a 6 point game, 10 minutes remaining.
And that's a man who's really upped his game as well, Mark Coleman, a brilliant young player, quiet by his standards, even though he did a lot of covering against Tipperary, but he's really won his battle there with Tom Morrissey. That Cork half back line really stood up. Mark Ellis has been very, very solid, and Robert Downey actually got injured. Christopher Joyce in there now, doing okay, but Niall O'Leary, you know, Stephen McDonald has had a very good second half since coming on. So very, very solid performance by the Cork backs.
Lots of changes have been made. Four substitutions and all now made in quick time by Limerick. Let's see, will they work? Tom Morrissey giving it off here. That was to Will O'Donoghue. Again, Flanagan involved. Tom Morrissey looking to try and eat into the 6 point lead. It's back to five. Morrissey's first point of this match. Plenty of time remaining.
Yeah, and you don't expect the All-Ireland champions to give up at home without a fight, and they won't.
Once again, Nash. Aidan Walsh drifting across, trying to win this one. But it's won instead by Declan Hannan, who was a superb captain for Limerick last year. That time, Cian Lynch trying to take it around Mark Coleman. Not easy. Cork players get back, work as a unit. But it's Coleman eventually who gets out with it. Slipping the hand pass towards Harnady. Has a support player. It's Darragh Fitzgibbon. There's a point for the taking, and Fitzgibbon takes it. First point of the match for him. Back out to a six-point difference once again. Beautiful support play, great teamwork, great grit and determination. Limerick now to respond. Kyle Hayes lost his stick. Possession back with Cork, and Daniel Carney working his socks off, as per usual. Up there towards Patrick Horgan, who's had seven wides in this match, but has also scored a goal and eight. Some afternoon for him. Out by Declan Hannan. Out to Tom Morrissey. Diagonally over there, read by Owen Cadogan. The shoulder coming in then of Barry Murphy. Stephen McDonald all the way back to the goalkeeper. Down through the centre. One to compete for. Players must be getting very tired at this stage. And the ball carried out near the sideline. They're giving it everything, and it's Tom Morrissey who's got it back again. Beautifully in, held on smartly. Cian Lynch is after it. Cian Lynch has got support players. Didn't give it out to Shane Dowling, and Cork get away with it. Nash gets the ball away, and you can see Shane Dowling looking at Cian Lynch saying, why didn't you give me the ball? Mark Coleman has it instead for Cork. All the way up as far as Seamus Harnady. Harnady setting off. Tom Morrissey looks beleaguered going after him. This is Shane Kingston, who's just come in. 3 points last week, and it still wasn't good enough to get a starting berth. It's Kingston. It's still Kingston. Hounded there by Diarmaid Burns, and Burns tracked them the whole way and prevented it going out for a 65 with Mike Casey's help. Declan Hannan now, 122 to 116. 64 minutes gone. Six to go plus stoppage time. Limerick have it all to do. Cian Lynch ready to do it. And the referee, away from the ball, blows his whistle and gives a free in to Limerick as Cian Lynch goes down in a heap.
Gerard, what a passage to play. We saw Cian Lynch onto the ball brilliantly. Used Shane Dowling on his left, Aaron Gillan on his right, and he didn't give the ball. You see here, this is just the free that's been given here. Cian Lynch been caught there with a chop, and the free in being given. And then we saw the other end of the field. Shane Kingston just came on straight down the middle, and again, maybe because he wasn't on, trying to get a score himself. Patrick Horgan free inside, could have flicked it to him, didn't give the ball, and danger cleared. Could have been a goal both sides.
Nervous moments for both teams at both ends, as Michael says. And the next piece of action will be a free in for Limerick. That's Niall O'Leary there, the UCC student. And the referee gives him a yellow card, and this is second match. On a ground today where he lost an under-21 final to Tipperary last August. And people were scratching their heads wondering about that. I wonder, will Aaron Gillan think about going for
not
it?
Not if you judge by the half hurdles. They're all back out in position and there's no one to follow in the ball if it's saved.
Well, you're right. Let's put it over. It's a ninth point by Aaron Gillan.
No, they're dead right. There's, what, five plus injury time. There's lots of time to go.
And interesting, Michael, that Cork have outscored Limerick 110 to some 7 points in the second half as Cork bring on yet another sub. And that's Limerick, rather, David Dempsey for Aaron Gillan. Collected here well. That was by Richie English, put under pressure, a lot of pressure, and it's Alan Cadogan stepped out over the line eventually. But what a contribution he has made since coming on after 5 minutes of play for the stricken Conor Lehan.
Well, you know, they've all been brilliant, but I think he's the man that maybe he just sparked the whole thing, Ger, today. He wasn't playing the last day, he wasn't available. And just since he came on, the energy, the commitment, the work rate, the scores he set up, the scores he scored, he's just overall, I think, attitude has really sparked this Cork team into a massive display.
Next man in will be Declan Dalton for Cork, it appears. From the sideline, it's caught here by Darragh Fitzgibbon. One back by Limerick and Kyle Hayes. Down into space. Across once again came Owen Cadigan. They're playing short, and eventually they're playing a little bit too dangerously for their own good and give that ball away to Limerick. Another change coming in then. It's Declan Dalton who comes in. He came out against Tipperary as well. And the player who's making his way off is Aidan Walsh. He played really well, Aidan Walsh. Worked exceedingly hard and certainly justified his inclusion. Line ball by Tom Morrissey. One back again by Cork. It's Shane Kingston back there helping. Runs into another player, Shane Dunling, but still managed to get that ball away out as far as Harnedy. Seamus Harnedy as far as Declan Dalton. First contribution back there to Bill Cooper. Look at the clock. 68 minutes are gone. Cork ahead by 122 to 117. Five the margin as Dalton plays it in and wallops it over the bar. Only on about 30 seconds. Fed the pass by Seamus Harnedy. Two East Cork men that were both involved in the Imokilly team to win a county, and Dalton was the goalkeeper at one stage.
Yeah, brilliant underage player. Limerick going short again.
Daniel Carney looks puzzled. Limerick will have the free. He's not too anxious to give the ball back, but now it is going to be a free for the All-Ireland and League champions who are up against last year's Munster champions here in Limerick this afternoon. Approaching the last 90 seconds of the 70 minutes. Dermot Burns will have to lob this one in and hope they get a goal. In towards Flanagan. Won by Cork. It was taken out there well. Out they come to Christopher Joyce. Joyce holding on to it. Getting into a little bit of difficulty there was Mark Ellis. And it is back once again with Shane Dowling. Cross towards Seamus Flanagan. Flanagan competing with Owen Cadigan. And the referee, I think, decided that Cadigan is guilty of a push in the back. Down went Flanagan, free into Limerick. They need a goal. And he knows it.
Yeah, look, good ball in again. Cadigan lost a hurl. Again, to me, that's a yellow card. It doesn't make any difference maybe at this stage of the game, but have to be consistent with your decisions. I don't know what went up there for injury time, Jerry. I don't know if you heard it.
Haven't seen it so far.
I think Limerick are going to have to try to work. Obviously 6 points now. We'll see what's left. This is a very difficult angle for Shane Dowling.
Well, he's produced some wonderful scores in the past. Let's see what he can do here. Dowling opts to put it over the bar and succeeds in that. His first point since coming on. So once again, it is a 5-point game. Into stoppage time, 5 minutes to go. It's still possible for Limerick, and Cork now need to hold on. Remember, Cork conceded 2:28 last week. That's a wonderful catch, brilliantly done. Harnedy, and just as Dalton was about to pull the trigger, stopped by Sean Finn, and out they come, out as far as Dermot Byrne. All the way across towards David Dempsey, the Napiershig man, can't hold it. Taken instead here by Mark Ellis. For a fellow who's out of the game for so long, he's done well at centre-back. Into Patrick Horgan, and Patrick Horgan, neat as you like, puts it over. He's got a goal and nine. Two of those points coming from open play. The goal, of course, as well, very much from open play after 52 minutes. Back come Limerick. Dan Morrissey. Into Flanagan, broken down. Raiding here is Barry Murphy. Stopped. Stopped well by Anthony Nash. Struck straight at him. Got his body behind it. Out to Mark Coleman. To Shane Kingston. Quickly turning away there from Kian Lynch, who's visibly tiring. Cork have that pep in their step still, which comes when you have a 6-point lead. And you're now about 3.5 minutes away from the final whistle. Pressure on. It's Owen Cadigan again who takes it. Out to his left-hand side. Out to the tireless Daniel Carney. It's a huge one. It's a massive one. The kind of thing you can do on a day like today when he's got 4 points and it's 125 now to 118.
Yeah, and all the big Cork men, I think, from last year really came back to form today. Mark Coleman, Darragh Fitzgibbon in the middle of the field, Daniel Kearney, you know, all Harnady, Patrick Horgan, all their top men in great form today, and they've completely out-hurled Limerick here.
Kian Lynch lobbing it back in there towards Flanagan. Barry Murphy trying to get to it. Taken away from him, however, by Stephen McDonald. Then he runs out of space, and eventually it needs Niall O'Leary to come in, once again intervene, make a massive contribution, get it out to another youngster, Darragh Fitzgibbon, back to O'Leary again. They were writing the obituary of this team 7 days ago about this time. And now here they are against the reigning All-Ireland champions, and they're ahead, even though Limerick have a late free, but are running rapidly out of time. Shane Dowling once again standing over this one. Well, there's a lot of bodies between Dowling and the goal, but he simply has to go for it.
He'll have a go.
Points no good at this stage.
No.
He's got a second one. Maybe that is just an acceptance of the reality of the situation they find themselves in. 6 points behind.
There's players down. It's been a tough, hard Munster Championship game. You know, Cork's season was over practically if they lost today, but they responded brilliantly. Limerick can be disappointed. They have a couple of games they'll benefit from today, and I think their game plan went out the window. Is that Kearney again?
Kearney again. He's got four and he's got to be happy with that. But it's a reality check for Limerick. They're right back down to earth again, having won the league at the end of March. They had the 7 week gap then. Whether that did them any good or not, I don't know. But they weren't as sharp as they might have been. Kian Lynch in as far as Tom Morrissey. Morrissey coming. Oh, change of heart. I'm not sure was he intending to hit that one, Tom Morrissey, and eventually passed it out. Basically passed the buck, and Cork are able to take it out. Mark Coleman has it again. Minute to go of added time. And this win for Cork here will really open up the Munster round-robin campaign as Declan Dalton gets a second point at the conclusion of this match, which Cork largely dominated in the second half.
And that was just an unbelievable ball from Mark Coleman. He looked up, Dalton made the run off camera, and he picked him out with a 70-yard pass straight into his hand. And, you know, Coleman is a genius of a hurler, and last week he just looked a bit sluggish, but today he's been immense.
Cork have led in this match since the 47th minute. Flanagan trying to touch it down. Well, both these teams and all the Munster teams will have a break next week before they get back into action again. And when they do, Limerick will have 3 matches to go. Cork will have 2. And they will all now be vitally important. On a day when Tipperary won again and they have 4 points, Cork now have 2. And they've come back from defeat last week when they were hopelessly out of sorts in many respects. And John Myler, and there with his selector Donal O'Mahony, they will be mighty pleased, relieved as well. The team came out, they showed the right attitude, their approach was perfect, they got the vital scores. And handshake of the managers here, the two Johns, John Kiley and John Myler. But you can be absolutely certain this is a huge win for Cork.
It is, Ger, and you know, it just shows you, sport's a funny thing. Last week I said it, Tipperary had been written off before the game, came with a massive display. Next thing on Monday morning, they were favourites for All-Ireland in a lot of places. But Cork's performance, their backs get maligned a lot of times. They were heroic, they were manly, they were tough. But from midfield up, Fitzgibbon with a point, Daniel Kearney 4 from play, Harnedy 4 from play, Luke Mead 2, Lahan got 1 before he went off, Cadigan with 3 from play, Horgan 1, 3 from play. And Declan Dalton, when he came on, 2 from play. Aidan Walsh didn't score, but was a huge creator.
He was
lot
immense,
of that.
Wasn't he?
He was immense. So, like, that is an unbelievable performance from 8 to 15 with Dalton, as I say. And when Cadigan came on, he lit a fire under Cork, and they were brilliant today. And it's brilliant. It's brilliant for the Munster Championship. If they had lost today, Waterford were well beaten in Turles. It could have been maybe turning into a bit of a damn squib. But we now have a full-blooded Munster Championship back in our hands, and that's what this round-robin is all about. What a performance by Cork. Limerick will come back from it. Well beaten today, well out-taught. their game plan didn't work. It was very one-dimensional to me, and they were outplayed, outsmarted, out-hurled by a brilliant Cork team.
Yeah, Cork in the end won by 7 points. Hope you enjoyed it. The full-time score here at the LIT Gaelic Grounds, it is Cork 126, Limerick 119.
Thank you, Ger. Thank you, Michael. Donal Logue, you called that. But when you look at the way that Cork performed, I mean, they didn't just beat Limerick. Did they dismantle the whole Limerick way of playing?
It was outstanding performance all over the field. From Anthony Nash, from Puck Oates, full back line, Owen Cadigan and Young O'Leary were immense today. Half back line was what I really liked about it. Look, we know you're at nothing without fighting spirit. To win in a competition like this, it's a fundamental. But Cork had a plan as well today. You could see it. We were watching it from behind the goals here. Cork knew what they were at defensively. Then you go to the middle of the field. Bill Cooper is a Trojan, right? The half-forward line, Daniel Kearney. Luke Mead was best performance I've seen Luke Mead in a long time. Inside, Alan Callaghan, his movement was outstanding. Might have been a break that Cork got. You know, was desperate to see Conor Lehane going off. But the minute Callaghan came on, his movement, his pace, his willingness to take the man on. Same with Horgan inside was outstanding. You could keep going. It's a fantastic win for Cork.
Well, Henry, you can tell by the fact that Donal Logue has just mentioned about 20 Cork players. The man of the match wasn't an easy decision to come to.
No, Anthony got his way. He wanted the defenders to win one today. But no, it was very hard to call. But Owen Cadigan was immense. I think we've been all talking about Cork's porous defence. But you need a rock back there. In Donal's time, that's what they had, a rock down there. And I think today, on the top performer in the league was Aaron Galan. Owen Cadigan did an immense job, as Donal said. And he was, by far and away, I think he was the best player for Cork today.
OK, let's hear now from our man of the match. That is the Cork fullback, Owen Cadigan. He is with Ivan.
Owen, congratulations. Questions were asked last week about this Cork defence, but you answered them today.
Yeah, I think that, look, last week's performance definitely wasn't up to scratch. We knew that ourselves. We identified a lot of things that didn't go the way we wanted. And coming up to the All-Ireland Champions, you know, we felt that today was as good as any to lay down a marker and try to show that, you know, we have the capability to perform, and thankfully it came out today.
This Munster Championship, this All-Ireland Championship, the home wins, the away wins. To get one here against the All-Ireland Champions, what will that do for confidence?
Yeah, look, the way the round robin is, you know, I suppose you can take it game by game. Last week, you know, we were on a very downward curve in the sense that there was a lot of, I suppose, poor morale around the test based on our performance. But I suppose today, there's a lot of people travelled from Cork. It's great to see the support here again today. Reset, refocus and go again in 3 weeks against Waterford.
Well, Owen Cadigan, you are the Centra Man of the Match, and Ray Lee from Centra is here to present you with your award.
Yeah, so Owen Cadigan talking there, Anthony, about talk of poor morale about the place. And the defence did come in for, as we said earlier, a huge amount of stick. And Owen Cadigan himself as well, people were questioning whether or not he should be starting.
Yeah, to be fair to him, Joanne, I would have felt he had a decent second half the last day. Stephen O'Leary, and they brought that on again. Fair play to Myler in that sense that he's picked him and stuck with him. And he really came up with the goods today, you know, and he was in young Galan's face all day, what we didn't see in the league, and thought he showed great example. There's great leadership in him. And Ellis coming back into centre back, he might have been in his jeans last Sunday, but you know, he's a man. And look, you talk all you like about tactics, John, and all this sort of stuff. What could they have changed in 7 days completely on the attitude? Attitude was 100% out there today. And Limerick's wasn't. Limerick was still stuck in the league zone, I'm afraid. And this is Championship, and it's a rude awakening now for Limerick.
But did they not change their tactics as well, though? Or did they just perform them properly?
Look, it's that one again. As I said, fighting spirit, intensity, all those things, they should be non-negotiable when you're going out to play.
Yes, but they got the game plan right, did they not?
Similarly, if you're playing without a plan, you're wasting your time as well. The seat of the pants coaching, that type of baloney, right? You need to have a system. And Cork had a system today and followed it.
Especially defensively, like. No, yeah, that's where it started. Like.
But you need the players to implement that. So who knows? They probably had a system last week. The lads just didn't probably perform it like they should have. I think Owen Cadigan touched on that. But definitely, like, they weren't sucked up the field. Daniel Kearney did a brilliant job tracking back. So it gave the opportunity to Mark Coleman and Robert Downey to cover that space. So Galan didn't get that oceans of space inside. All Cadigan had to do was to stop him getting it. And next thing, the lads had funneled back and away they went. And they have the hurlers to work the ball up the field and get the scores. Like, they scored 114 the second half compared to Limerick's 8 points. They just totally took over.
So that's when our tipper got a mile ahead of everybody.
But we've flagged it beforehand, Joanne. Like, the day for one-on-one defending is gone, right? Because forwards are too good, the balls are too good, the referees are refereeing the game, making sure that they're protecting the attackers. And the other thing is, one man trying to dispossess an attacker with the ball, wherever it is in the field. At least today with Cork, you're the first player coming in, putting them under pressure, but then very often it's the second player who'll actually take the ball off them. To do that, you need commitment, and it was a marked difference of last week.
But I think we talk about the defence a lot here. As well as that, the forwards, the work rate they put in, like Aidan Welch didn't score today, but he was like a nuisance, as we said off air here. Just getting in, getting blocks in, getting hooks in, putting the body in. And that puts Limerick under pressure, not the opportunity to look up, head up, where's Galan going? They didn't have that. So they just worked as a team. There was a serious cohesion between them all today.
Yeah, the Munster Championship has definitely come alive for this year. We have so much more analysis and reaction to come. Their attitude has been questioned by some, but Cork's hurlers have answered most questions sent their way in the past 7 days with victory over the All-Ireland champions. And how different does that make the table look? Tipperary and Clare still on top, but Cork on the same number of points, and it's Limerick and Waterford yet to get off the mark. Still lots of hurling to play though, including Waterford against Limerick, Clare against Tipperary in a couple of weeks' time. Let's hear now from the Cork manager. John Myler is with Ivan.
John, you needed a win. You wanted one. You got a 7-point win, but you also got a really strong performance today.
Yeah, well, after last week, it wasn't really hard to get a performance today, but our work rate was up, our tackling was up, our, you know, decision-making was up, and, you know, the lads deserve great credit, you know, from Nash out to Cads, and really, really put in a performance today. But as I said earlier, we need to build on that, as distinct from the two league matches against Limerick and against Tipperary. So we need to build on that now for Waterford in 3 weeks' time.
But surely this will do a lot for momentum.
It will, but, you know, we were up and down in the league, and I don't want to be up and down. I want to be consistent with that same performance and better the next day against Waterford. And that's really it, because Waterford will come to Parky Keeve looking for a win as well.
It was nip and tuck, but once Pat Horgan scored that goal, it looked like you just ran away with it and the momentum went your way.
Yeah, but the benefit of having the game last week probably freshened us up a bit. And, you know, Limerick were coming in cold there today, but once Hoggy got in there and got that goal, it really drove us on. And, you know, we were determined really not to let what happened in the All-Ireland semi-final last year when we lost a 6-point lead. And, you know, we just kept ticking, getting a few points, and that was really it.
Owen Cadogan got man of the match despite some of amazing performances in the forwards, but that'll just show you what you're in.
Cadogan has won an All-Ireland football medal, and you know, he's a real leader, and he's a real, you know, genuine good guy, and, you know, puts his heart on the, that's it.
Yeah, it just goes to show that you do have players all over the field, and you've got that work rate you spoke about.
Yeah, well, we got the work rate, and then we introduced five subs to lose Lahan after a few minutes, and then to bring in someone like Alan Cadogan with his calibre, and Shane Kingston, Dalton came in and got 2 points, so, you know, they contributed, and that's really, really important as well.
You have a rest now before you play Waterford. Do you know anything about those injuries, about Conor Lehan, about the lads that came off?
No, we'll get the medical team to look at those this evening, but I'm sure they'll all want to play against Waterford. I've no doubt about that, so we'll get Lehan back in those, you know.
Okay, John, congrats.
Thanks very much.
John Myler spoke about an awful lot of his players who performed well, but there's no doubt about it that the management team got lots right today. And we know Anthony Daly at the start of this afternoon spoke about how Tipperary dismantled Cork's puckouts last week. Was that one of the things upon which Cork built this victory today?
Yeah, and John, there wasn't massive science to it in terms of, you know, it wasn't all about runners and all. It was more about breaking the ball through that Limerick halfback line. And as a halfback, your first job is to block that ball from going through. You must not let the ball go into the likes of Alan Cadogan and these guys, Hoggy. And you see, Nash, just route one, but like, they're not getting back far enough. You must get back far enough. Cork buys out first to us. Alan Cadogan, you know, running into a wall, but spots Luke Need outside him, creates a point, set the tone for the second half in lots of ways. And again, I think this was the third puck out. Straight up. There's no great
you know, there's no massive running, but it gets through. The Limerick half-back line are not attacking it. And Cadigan's on his game. He comes onto that ball. They're the shooters. They're the scorers. They're the ones you don't want to go through to. You want to be blocking it down to where Kyle Hayes, Tom Morrissey, Keane Lynch. And at one stage, I looked out, you know, that Keane Lynch was roaring at the half-back line to break the ball down. They do the rest in after that, but that malfunctioned completely today. Credit Cork for that as well.
And that sometimes happens, you know. They can think we might have to do the fancy thing. We have to go up high and grab it. It's not. It's get the basics right. You said stop that ball and let Keane Lynch come onto it.
It looked like it was going to be neck and neck like it was in the first half, and Cork had moved a point clear. And then once they got that goal, it just seemed that they just seemed to pull away after that.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, and it actually came from a nervous enough situation in the Cork defence. Steve McDonald gets the ball up well, does the right thing. Anthony Nash is clear there. There's nothing at all wrong with that. Anthony takes his eye off it. What I like here is the recovery of the Cork players and Mark Coleman. Composure. Like, you know, you can't place a value on that. Luke Mead then onto Bill Cooper. Excellent stuff.
And Bill Cooper in, long ball in. Just Mike Casey. Horgan losing for a second. We were showing earlier on with Bonamar. It was just a touchdown there. You know, it was just immense. And once he got through, we're just right behind it here. There was no chance for Nicky Quaid in the goal. But it was the touchdown. Mike Casey thought for a second he could catch it. Horgan just came in, kept his eye on the ball, used the speed of the ball just to touch it in front of him. And
very,
it was just
very hard
brilliant.
To defend against it. Like, it was yeah. just a G. He waited, timed his run, little touch to himself.
Yeah, well, Casey thought Horgan was gone, so he thought he had yeah. the division, and just Horgan snuggling in the last
second.
Brilliant.
What a genius.
And we did think perhaps Limerick might come back, but just Cork seemed to have, with the exception probably of Keane Lynch, who did battle all the way to the end, Cork just did seem to have the upper hand around that middle third. And how often have we said that about Limerick? That
yeah,
they were
like
dominated.
That was the big thing today, Joanne. Like, that was one of the stories of Limerick last year as to how they dominated that area, kept possession. But time and time again today, Cork were winning the battles all over that middle eight. Keane Lynch is an outstanding player, and he did keep fighting, but he didn't have the impact that he had in previous occasions. And again, like what we've been saying, it's consistent what we've been speaking about. It's about the half forwards coming back in there, supporting the half backs. You even see Patrick Horgan coming out for it there. How many times do we see the likes of Kyle Hayes and those guys today trying to win possession, and you had a Cork player coming on him, and not alone one Cork player, but you've seen this
swarming
example,
it,
two
yeah.
swarming in around.
Yeah,
pure desire, like, absolutely. Kearney was brilliant coming deep. I thought Cooper steadied things, but Dara Fitzgibbon was back to his very best, and you see him. He was in the middle of that tackling zone, and he's above getting the point.
When your half forwards are coming out, what that causes is that your midfielders can actually take the chance and go on beyond, because they know that the half forwards are covering for you. It's a game of absolute movement, no, Joanne, and I think Cork's style in the middle eight typified that today.
What does it mean from a Limerick point of view? Was it a case that, look, it's the first game back, that's being All-Ireland champions and not being used to that coming into Championship? Why is it that they weren't able to compete, apart from the fact that Cork played well, at the level that we've become accustomed to?
Well, I think, look, emotion plays a massive part in this game. And I think, you know, this week Cork would be hurting, and they were going to come with fire in their bellies. Limerick couldn't talk about it, but they haven't had that experience. They sailed through the league while a lot of teams were pulling back in the league. And I think their game plan, because they are Ireland champions, everyone is talking about them. Everyone is going through in fine detail what they're doing. So Cork were well prepared for it today. And I just think that bit of flatness came in. So, and it's very hard just to switch it on. We can talk about intensity in training matches, but there's nothing like Munster Championship to bring that.
OK, let's hear what the manager of Limerick has to say all about that. John Kiely is now with Ivan.
John, not the start you would have wanted, especially at home in this Munster Championship.
Absolutely. Listen, bottom line is it was a below par performance. And, you know, we paid a heavy price for it. Simple as that.
We talked before the game about, you know, coming in cold and not having a game under your belt. Do you think that played a part today?
It didn't seem to play a part in the first half, you know. I think bottom line is, you know, when we came out in the second half, Cork got, I think, the first two scores, and we just never seemed to get to the pitch of it in the second half. Our work rate wasn't strong enough, and Cork just seemed to get to the ball before us. I think that was one of the aspects of the second half. They were always first to the ball in the second half, and they just seemed a hungrier team, and they got the result for it.
Yeah, like you say, the second half didn't really go according to plan. The scores didn't come as thick and fast.
No, we struggled to get scores in play. We got a few scores in freeze, all right, but and we created one or two goal chances, but we didn't take them, and that's the bottom line. You have to take your chances.
Nash foiling a few late chances as well. It could have turned maybe the last 5 or 6 minutes.
I don't think so, no. Listen, no. Cork had the wind at their back at that stage, I think, you know, but you know, maybe 7 or 8 minutes to go even, you know, you could see that they had strong momentum behind them. It was going to take a huge effort from our guys to turn it around. We created one or two goal chances, we didn't take them, that was it.
What kind of pressure are you under now? You do have a week off, but then you've got three games coming thick and fast after that.
Listen, all we can do right now is make the best use of the next 2 weeks, go down to Waterford, try and put a result together down there and try and get a good performance out of ourselves first and foremost. And without that down there, there's no further after that.
How will you go about lifting their heads?
They'll do it. You know, listen, we'll do it together. We've been in dark places before, so, you know, listen, it's not the end of the world. It's one game out of three. You know, I think there's definitely the wherewithal within that dressing room for these guys to turn around. You know, they've worked hard. They know they've the work done. Okay, they had a poor second half today. There's three more games to go. We will have a say in this championship yet, there's no doubt. And they'll work hard to make sure that they have.
John, thanks very much.
Okay, thank you.
Not a brilliant bullish end to that interview because he seemed so dark at the start of it, but he finished on a positive note. Just after what Henry said there about the fact like everybody's kind of worked out what Limerick are going to do, one of the things Limerick are famed for is the fact that Kiely and Paul Kinnerk come up with these systems. So surely we must expect some sort of a tweak, something different from Limerick to make them not as easy to read, if that's the correct way of putting it.
Yeah, I suppose, look, Joanne, I would say as well, like Henry, we had a bit of a laugh about it beforehand about the cup not going to pubs, but it does take an awful lot out of you in Ireland, especially if you're a first time in a long time team, because there's so many, if it's not pubs,
functions,
schools,
no, it's
and
functions,
everything that's
open.
We can't really calculate that, the drain on that. And they were flat today for some reason. Maybe they put a bit too much into the league. We all thought that was the right way to go. Maybe it didn't. But the big thing is, like, they have the 2 weeks now before they go to Waterford. A wounded Waterford, let's say, after the two games. Like,
but Waterford, do you think they might be back in with a chance
now? That's the thing, though. Park Fannin, an hour and a half ago, maybe 2 hours ago, was saying we're probably gone. But now they're saying we'd absolutely have a chance here if we can turn them over on our own patch. Are we going to back it up? So it's set up now for the next few weeks.
Oh, it's going to be brilliant. We will have further analysis and highlights of the weekend's main championship action with Des and the lads tonight at 9:30. But that's it for this afternoon. A big thank you to Donal Oak, to Anthony and to Henry for their time on a day when the All-Ireland champions began the defence of their title with a pretty heavy defeat. Do make sure you join us in Galway next Sunday for our first live game from the Leinster Championship. But for now, from all of us here, bye-bye. Oh, if the ship goes down, then I'm going down with it. Oh, if it hits the